What's up? Seems like you guys got a good camaraderie already around the, amongst the rookies. You know, what's it been like just you all experiencing the NFL together for the first time?
I felt good. During the OTAs and minicamp, we were already together. Like, after practice, we all hung out with each other and stuff like that just so we can bond more and stuff like that. And I know Ye from a long time, playing against him too. So I had a good camaraderie with him already. So, but yeah. And then also Pac, a teammate of mine too. So we already basically like bonded already from that. So,
Felix, how hard was today?
Today, I'm not gonna lie. Today was tough. Obviously, almost every first fall camp, like even in college, every first fall camp is always gonna be tough. You already got to get you have to get in shape, football shape, because all the training and stuff like that is not the same as football shape. So today was tough. Hopefully, these next 3 days is gonna be easier, and then when the vets come, we'll already be in shape and ready to go.
You were coming off the hand injury during OTAs. How are you feeling now? Do you feel 100%? Do you think that you're still trying to get comfortable with?
Yeah, my hand's 100%. Like, everything's fine.
Did you know that in the Sugar Bowl? Is that
what? I heard that in the Big 12 Championship. Last play the game. Literally. No, last defensive play the game. Yeah. So.
In the Big 12 Championship.
Championship. I didn't know it was torn until I went to start training. And then they told me to get surgery right after pro day. So.
How tough was it to be limited?
It was very tough, especially they drafted me to play right away, drafted me for first round, so all the coaches expect a lot out of me. So it was just very hard and very tough that I can't do exactly what they want me to do right away. So it was just a lot of mental reps, a lot of mental just learning the playbook, a lot of knowing their technique and stuff like that. Even though I can't do it on the field, it's just I got to do it mentally.
How do you keep your mind right? Because like you said, they want you to do so much right away, and sometimes you felt like maybe you're just not there yet. How do you just keep yourself to keep going and know that you'll get there at some point?
Personally, I lean back on my teammates, especially the rookies. They all know that what my position is. They already know like how big it is, especially I'm a hometown kid. Especially like everybody leaning on me and all that stuff. So they always try to preach me up because they know it's very different in my shoes, especially being a first-round draft pick in your hometown. They know it's very different, so they always try to keep my head up, try to keep me motivated to keep going, and try to keep me just basically tell me every day that what the goal is, so that I'm eventually going to get better. I'm eventually going to be hopefully playing. So.
You talked a minute ago about the expectations the coaches have. What are your expectations for yourself as a rookie?
My expectation is just bottom line, just get through the playbook, just learn from the vets, because obviously the vets, they won a Super Bowl championship. So I even said it before in another press conference. They already been in this position. So I need to learn as much as I can from the vets and as much as I can just from my coaches so I can be able to help the team out.
You mentioned learning a playbook. Spags defense is known to be pretty tough. How far along are you in the playbook and how much have you actually learned so far?
I don't know how to really answer that question. I'm pretty decent with the playbook. Obviously, I'm new. I'm just learning the playbook now, so I just need to keep going in the playbook, learning every day by day. Ask the coaches, ask the vets, just like pointers and stuff like that, and just honestly focus on. So we got quite a bit of time, just especially this whole camp. So hopefully by then I'll have this playbook down. So,
you mentioned getting drafted in your hometown. How has your life in Kansas City changed since you did get drafted a couple months ago?
It's just had to move differently. Obviously, I can't really move the same. I can't really go to grocery stores because everybody thinks I'm a celebrity now. So it's very different, I will say. But at the same time, it comes with the price, being drafted to hometown and all that stuff. So I knew if me doing that's going to come. So I just had to move differently.
Have your buddies at home from high school and your buddies at K-State kind of kept your ego in check?
Oh, they know I'm not the high ego type guy. They know that they know how humble I am. I never even like try to rub in their face about where my position is at the same time, because at the end of the day, God gave me this gift, and God gave everybody a different journey. So I never ever want to even rub it in their face. I hang out with them almost all the time. Like this past Saturday, I hang out with my high school friends, just hanging out with them before I go to training camps, because I won't see them for a minute because they're going to go back to college. So
let's go. Last four. Go ahead, Nick.
Yeah,
so I believe before you said
you
come up here to camp as a kid, what was that first day
like for you being on the other side of the fence? I had to soak it all in at first because I remember just sitting at the stands. I believe it was 2013, sitting at the stands just watching all the guys, and then me actually walking on this grass pad just to come down to campus. It's a dream come true, but at the same time, although I'm in this dream, I have to show for it. So.
Blair.
I just wanted to ask you to set the record straight. Who got the better of the Oklahoma matchups with you and Wanye?
Wanye, I'm not gonna lie. I didn't go against Wanye or last year, but the year before that, I did get a sack on you. Even if you can check my record and stuff like that, you'll see. Like he knows it too, because I was always rubbing in his face all the time. But no, he's a great player. He trash talk, but at the same time, he keeps it like cordial. Because there's one time like my whole chain was out. He's like, hey, chuck your chain before one of my teammates tried snatching it. So like he's respectful too. So I appreciate him for that.
Bye, PJ.
Talk about being a local celebrity from here, everything. How important is it just for you to keep that tight circle that you're gonna and people are gonna invade that and try?
Oh, it's a lot. There's a lot of people that obviously haven't came in my life for a long time. Always already try to like, hey, this and that. Try to talk me up, stuff like that. So I always like to keep it people that have been with me all the way throughout the whole process, like close friends and all that stuff. So I always keep that circle small. So I don't have any distractions outside.
You got a long way to go before the first game, right? Yep. But you've already come a long way since the night you got drafted.
Yep.
You asked about your expectations before. Have they changed at all now that you've gotten to be a part of this for a while? Do you feel more confident, or is it a bigger challenge than you thought?
It's still, at the same time, I still got to impress the coaches. It's still the same thing day by day, is impress the coaches. Because at the end of the day, if you don't impress the coach, you're not going to get on the field. So obviously, learning that playbook, learning my technique, doing everything that is possible for the coaches to be impressed by what I do on the field will eventually, hopefully, have me on the field.
Last one, Dave.
You mentioned before, obviously, about playing for your hometown team. I guess my question is, from the draft to the start of camp, was there a moment where somebody from Kansas City said something to you that was either inspiring or sort of moving, given where you are in your career right now?
And say that one more time. I'm so sorry. I lost your thought.
No, you're good. Was there anybody from Kansas City that you know, or maybe it was a stranger or an acquaintance that said something to you about playing for the Chiefs that you're going to take with you, or at least it inspired you or motivated you?
Really, I remember I was on the float with Dante Hall. Basically, he said it really simple. Just honestly, you play football for a reason. Just go out and play. There's nothing. There's no thought into it. There's no overthinking it. Just go out there and play, because at the end of the day, this is just a game. So once you just play literally just a game like how I did in Little League, and just play, do everything right, do everything possible, eat right, do everything, work on your body, everything will just play to play. So that's basically the most simplest thing he said, and I'll take that forever.
How meaningful was it to have someone that you probably watched growing up?
It was very meaningful, especially just literally the day, like 2 days before, I just seen him. I was just like, It's very meaningful, especially the position he was, because he was that guy on the Chiefs. So it was just very meaningful just to be next to him, just him giving me some advice.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.